for next week, I want you to work on the lemon exercise. So that week, I went to the grocery store, bought a lemon, brought it home, I cut it up, and I ate it. And then, you know, the next time I was in the class, I told him that. He goes, "You ate a lemon?" I still don't know what the point of that exercise is.
And sometimes I felt like, oh, damn, I'm not good at this. I don't know how to do that. There's a certain kind of acting that really suits Aaron's writing. Maybe I'm not right for this. But I think that sometimes that feeling is quite productive and creative, and sometimes the very feeling of feeling like you're entirely the wrong person for the job adds something really interesting to your performance.
There's 1,000 terrible versions of every improv film that I've ever done, and certainly somebody who wasn't an adept storyteller in the editing room could have made a bunch of bad movies out of the things that we said.
And I'd rather be like one really specific, magnificent color of paint for a painter than like a general freaking beige that they can use in like every single movie.
What do you need from a director?
All of my directors, who were great directors, said surprise me. I had to go back 10 years. I had to in order to go to work. And my fierceness, I can feel it now, my fierceness about I'm gonna make up for that time was so inbred in me that whatever I had to do to keep on working in film was what I was going to do.
Filmmaker Magazine presents Back to One with Peter Rinaldi.